Please click on subscribe button and click on bell icon for more interesting updates on civil engineering concepts. In this video lecture, I will explain you analysis and designing of G plus 14 story building, which is consisting of 15 stories building for different column sizes, for different beam sizes, for different slab thickness by using StatPro V8A software. So initially I will show you the specification which is related to your respected building considerations so that you can easily understand the concept. So for the respected G plus 14 story building, for the 15 slabs building, I will consider the dimensions of the column sizes for the first story to fifth slab, which is equals to 0.5 meter. For the sixth slab to 10th slab, I will consider the column sizes 0.4 x 0.4. For the 11th slab to 15th slab, I will consider the column sizes 0.3 x 0.3. in the same process, for the beam sizes, I will consider the first slab to fifth slab is 0.5 x 0.23. for the sixth slab to 10th slab is 0.4 x 0.23. for the 11th slab to 15th slab, I will consider it as 0.3 x 0.23. for the slab thickness, I will consider the first slab to fifth slab is 180 mm, and for the sixth slab to 10th slab, I will consider it as 150 mm, and for the 11th slab to 15th slab, I will consider 120 mm. Okay, so this is also one of the important concept in building designing process. So go to click on StatPro software initially. So click on StatPro software here. So initially click on new project option, select spacing option, give the file name, just I'm considering here as G+14. Save your file location as per your format and select the length units will be in meter and force units will be in kilonewton. Click on next button, click on finish button. Now the grid lines will be open here like this, which is consisting of 10 number of the grid lines in horizontal position and 10 number of the grid lines in vertical position. So initially we need to add the frame model for this respected building section. So for that, go to geometry option. So click on run structure wizard option. So in this we need to select the frame models option here like this. So here I'm selecting bay frame. Let us consider the length of this respected building will be consisting of 21 meter, and height of the respected building is 45 meter, and width of this respected building just I'm considering here as 18. So number of base along length direction just I'm taking here as 7, and number of base along height direction just I'm taking here as 15, and number of base along width direction just I'm considering here as 6. Click on apply option. Now we can see that frame model will be open here like this, which is consisting of 21 meter length and 18 meter width, and height of this respected building is 45 meter. Now we have to import this respected model from structure wizard option to StatPro software. So for that, initially we need to click on the cancel option, click on yes option, click on OK. Now we can see all the model is imported to this respected options. So after importing this respected model, initially we need to add the slab section for this G plus 14 story building. So for that, initially we need to click on the front view option, go to cut section commands, click on selective view, click on OK. So initially I am cutting this respected portion. So click on 3D view option. Now we have to add the slab section for this. So for that, initially I am selecting the generate surface meshing option. Otherwise you can consider here as 4-node plate also, depends upon your considerations. So here I am considering the surface meshing option for generating the diagonal loading condition. So here I am select quadrilateral meshing here, click on OK. So in this we need to consider the divisions. So as per my consideration, just I'm assuming 1 meter will be consisting of one division. So for that, just I'm considering divisions are 3 3 3 3 here in X and Y direction condition. Click on apply option. So now we can see the slab section is added here like this. So after that, we have to copy this respected slab to the remaining sections. So for that, firstly we will select this respected slab cursor, select all the slabs, go to transitional repeat. In X direction condition, just we have to copy this respective slab to the 6 numbers. So here I am selecting the number of steps are 6, and each step will be consisting of 3 meter. Click on OK option. So after that, again in the same process, we have to copy this respective slab in Z direction also. So for that, we have to select all the slabs here. So now we have to copy this, go to transitional repeat. In Z direction condition, number of steps will be consisting of 5, each step will be consisting of 3 meter here. Now we can see all the slabs are copied to the Z direction distance also. So after that, we have to click on the whole structure command. Now we have to copy this respective slabs to the remaining floors here for the remaining 14 slabs. So for that, initially we need to select the plate cursor. Just I'm selecting all the plates, go to transitional repeat, which is in Y direction condition, and number of steps will be of 14, and each step will be consisting of 3 meter height. Click on OK. So now we can see all the plates will be copied for this respected vertical direction distance for the remaining 14 stories here like this. So after that, we have to see this respected model in rendering view. So for that, click on 3D rendering view option. So now we can see the 3D rendering view for this respected building is shown here. which is consisting of the 21 meter length of the building and width of the building is 18 meter and height of the building is 45 meter. So after modeling process completed, just we have to add the properties for this building, which is nothing but the beam size, column size and slab thickness as per the definition. So for that, initially we have to click on the general option here. So initially we have to define the properties for the column section, beam section and slab section. So click on define option initially, select the rectangular section. Initially I am taking the 0.5 cross 0.5 for the first 5 floors. Again I am considering 0.23 cross 0.5 for the first 5 floors for the beams. So again I am considering 0.4 cross 0.4 for the column section, which is exist for 6th story to 10th story. Click on add option. Again I am considering 0.4 cross 0.23 for the beam section, which is from 6th to 10th story. So again I am considering 0.3 cross 0.3 for the column section, which is there for the remaining 5 stories. Again I am taking 0.3 cross 0.23 for the beam sections. So after that we have to consider the slab thickness. So click on thickness option. So firstly I will take the thickness, which is of 180 mm. Let us consider 18 add option. Again I am considering 150 mm. Again in the same process, just I am taking 120. So after that we have to assign these respective properties for the building section. So firstly we will select the front view option. So initially we have to apply the properties for the first 5 floors. So for that we have to cut the portion which is of 5 stories. So go to cut section command, click on select 2 view option, click on OK. So here I am selecting first story, second story, third story, fourth story, fifth story, here like this. So firstly we have to select 0.5 cross 0.5 for the column section. Go to select beams parallel to Y condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. Now I am selecting beam sizes, go to select option, beams parallel to X condition system. Again I am selecting beams parallel to Z condition system, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that we have to assign the plate thickness, select the plate thickness. By using a plate cursor we have to select all the plates here, click on assign to selected plates, assign yes option. So after that we have to click on the whole structure command here. Now in the same process we have to keep the structure in front of you. Again we have to cut the remaining 5 slabs, go to cut section command, click on select 2 view option, select OK option. So select the beam cursor. So here I am selecting remaining 5 slabs, first slab, second slab, third slab, fourth slab, fifth slab, here like this. So again we have to assign the properties, which is related to 0.4 cross 0.4, 0.4 cross 0.23. So select 0.4 cross 0.4, go to select option, beams parallel to Y condition system, click on assign to selected beams, assign. So 0.4 cross 0.23, go to select beams parallel to X direction. Again we have to select the beams parallel to Z direction, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. So after that we have to select the plate thickness, go to select your plate thickness option here, select all these respective plates, click on assign to selected plates, assign yes. So after that again we have to click on the whole structure. Again we have to select the front view, go to cut section command here. Now in the same process we have to select the select to view option, click on OK. So select the beam cursor, select all these respected floors here like this. Now go to select your 0.3 cross 0.3, go to select option, beams parallel to Y condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. Select 0.23 cross 0.3, go to select option, beams parallel to X direction, go to select option, beams parallel to Z, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. So after that we have to select the plate thickness option, go to select option by using the plate cursor. So click on assign to selected plates, assign yes. So after that we have to click on 3D view. So now we have to see the rendering view for this respected building section after applying the properties. So click on 3D rendering view option. Now we can see this is a 3D rendering view for this respected building, which is consisting of 0.5 cross 0.5 column size at the first 5 stories, and it will be consisting of 0.4 cross 0.4 for the remaining 5 stories for the column size, and it will be consisting of 0.3 cross 0.3 for the last 5 floors. So it will be consisting of different types of the beam sizes and different thickness of the slab section as per the consideration. So after modeling process completed, we need to apply the support condition system. Okay, so go to general option for that, select support condition, click on create option. Initially we need to add the fixed supports. Why? Because in building structure consideration we will consider the fixed supports at the base. So select all the node points at the base by using assign to selected nodes, assign yes option. So after applying the support condition, we need to apply the load cases. So this respected building of G plus 14 story will be comes under your high rise structure. Okay, basically we need to consider the seismic loading condition as well as wind loading condition for designing of this respected structure. So for that reason only, initially we need to define the parameters which is related to the seismic loading condition and wind loading condition. So for that initially we need to click on the loads and definition, select the definitions option, select the wind definitions initially. Click on add option. So firstly I will select the type 1 wind 1, add button, close option. Select type 1 wind 1 here, click on add. So here we have to calculate the intensity as per the IS-875 Part 3 code. So as per my rough estimation, just I'm considering the intensity here, which is of 1 kN/m², which is acting at a distance of 45 m. Again I'm considering 0.6, which is acting at a distance of, let us consider here as 30. Again I'm considering 0.3, which is acting at a distance of some example of 15 m, let us consider. So again I'm considering 0.1 intensity, which is acting at a distance of 5 m. Let us consider an example. Click on add option. So again we have to add the exposure factor as 1. So click on add button, close option. So after that we have to select the exposure 1 by using assign to V option, assign yes option. So after assigning the exposure factor, we need to define the load case which is related to the seismic condition. Select the seismic definition, click on add button. So firstly we will select the IS codal provision which is related to the IS-1893 codebook. So click on generate option. So here we have to select the parameters which is related to the seismic loading condition as per the seismic coefficient factor and as per the response reduction factor, impedance factor, soil type. We have to select the parameters. So initially I am selecting the zone which is comes under your high seismic zoning condition under the special RC movement resisting frames. And important buildings will be consisting of impedance factor of 1 and medium soil condition. Click on generate option. Now we have to change the damping ratio 0.05. Click on add option. So now we have to consider the self-weight factor as 1, add button. Again we have to consider the member weight. So here we have to consider the member weight which is related to the higher dimensions of the beam. So as per the definition, as per the considerations of the building section, we are taking the higher dimensions of the beam is 0.5 × 0.23. just we have to calculate the dead load for that respected beam section. 0.5 × 0.23 multiplied by unit weight of the concrete, which is equals to 2.875. so we need to apply that respected intensity, which is of uniform load, minus 2.875. click on add option, close option. So after that we have to select the uniform load. So go to select option, we have to select the beams parallel to X condition initially. Again we have to select the beams parallel to Z condition. Click on assign to selected beams option here, assign here S option. So after applying this respected member weight, we need to define the load cases. Okay, so for that firstly we have to select the load case details. Click on add. So initially we need to add the seismic loading condition. Why? Because we are defining the seismic loading condition initially in the definition part, so that we can add that seismic loading condition. So for that just I am selecting the seismic load here. So select the title as earthquake load, which is in X condition. Again I am adding earthquake load, which is in Z condition. In the same process we have to add the wind load condition system here. Just I am adding wind X. Again I am selecting wind load, which is in Z condition. So now I am selecting the dead load condition system, DL, add button. Again I am selecting the lie load condition system, LL, add button. So now we have to apply this respective load cases for the building. So initially I am selecting earthquake load X. Click on add button. So here we have to select the seismic loading condition. Select the seismic load, which is consisting of direction is X with factor 1, add, close. Again we have to apply the Z direction load case. So select this respected load case, click on add button. Select the seismic loading condition initially, Z direction, which is consisting of the factor 1, add, close. Now I am selecting wind load, which is in X direction condition. Click on add option. So firstly we will select the wind load here, which is having the wind facing direction wind load, which is with factor 1, add button. Again I am considering the factor as minus 1, add button. So after that we have to add the wind load, which is in Z direction condition with factor 1. Click on add option for that. Select the wind load with a Z direction factor with the factor 1, add. Again I am considering the factor as minus 1, add button. So after that we have to apply the dead loading condition. So under the dead loading condition, it will be consisting of your respected parameters like self weight condition, external wall load, internal wall load and parapet wall load. We need to consider the major load cases. So along with that we will consider the floor load condition system also. So for that just I am selecting the dead load initially, click on add. Initially I will add the self weight. So after that we have to add the intensity for your respected external wall load. Basically we will consider the external wall load will be consisting of 0.23 thickness multiplied by your respected unit weight of the brickwork, let us consider here as 20, multiplied by each floor height, which is consisting of 13.8 kN/m intensity. So here I am considering minus 13.8 kN/m intensity, which is acting downward direction. So again in the same process you have to consider the internal wall load, 0.125 multiplied by 20 multiplied by 3, which is equals to 7.5. so for that initially I am adding the one more load case, which is related to the minus 7.5. let us consider. click on add. So after that we have to add the intensity for the parapet wall load. So go to select your 0.125 multiplied by 20 multiplied by, let us consider 1.2 meter height. So it will be consisting of -3 kN/m. Just I am considering -3, click on add. So after that we had to add the floor load condition system. So initially I will apply this respective load cases. Select the self weight by using assign to view, assign yes option. So go to select your uniform load, which is related to the -13.8 intensity. So we had to select the beams which is parallel to X condition, Y condition. So go to select option, beams parallel to X direction. Again in the same process we had to select the beams which are parallel to Z direction condition. Click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that select your -7.5 intensity, assign to selected beams, assign yes. Again in the same process we have to assign the -3. Go to click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. So after that we have to add the floor load condition system. So go to select dead load condition, click on add. Initially we will select the floor load. Just I am considering floor load will be consisting of -2, which is acting at a distance of 3 meter and 45 meter. Click on add option here. Okay, so click on close. So after that we have to assign the live load condition system. Select the live load here, click on add option. Now we have to select the floor load, which is consisting of, let us consider the intensity as per my consideration, just I am taking -3, which is acting at a distance of 3 meter and 45 meter. Click on add option. So after adding this respective load cases, we need to add the load combinations also. Go to select load case details, click on add option. Select the auto load combination here. So you can consider the auto load combination, depends upon your consideration. Otherwise you can consider the load combinations as per the IS codal provision. So here I am selecting as per the Indian code. So click on generate structure, general structure. So click on add option. So it will add your respective load combinations here like this for this respected building. So after that go to analysis and print again. So before that we need to assign the materials. So go to your general option, materials here. Select the concrete, select the assign to view option, assign yes option. So after that we have to analyze this respective structure. Go to analysis and print, add your no print, close option. Go to analyze option, run analysis, save option. So here we have to check for the zero errors for this respected model under considerations of your respected different types of the load cases. Okay, so it will take around 5 to 10 minutes of analysis, depends upon your configuration of the system. So after analysis process completed, I will show you the results which is related to the deflection value, shear values, bending values, torsion values. So after that I will design the respected building as per IS codal provision. Now you can see here my model is observed with zero errors. Go to post processing mode, click on done option. So apply your load cases, click on OK. So now we can see this is a deflection diagram. Due to presence of your live loading condition, you can change the deflection diagram intensity to the dead loading condition. So depends upon your loading condition, the deflection diagram will be shown here like this. So after that we have to show the shear force diagram. So further select FY value. So deselect the deflection diagram values here. So this is a shear force diagram for this respective structure under considerations of the dead load condition. So now select MZ value, which is related to the bending moment diagram. So now we can see this is the bending moment diagram for this respected building under considerations of the load cases. So after that we have to see the output file for the slab sections. So go to plate pressure, apply your stress type here as absolute pressure, click on apply here, click on OK option. So this is the plate pressure for this respected building under considerations of the dead loading condition structure. Okay, so after analysis process completed, we need to design this respected building as per the IS codal provision. So for that go to modeling option, select the design option. So select the concrete design. So initially I am selecting the IS codal provision, which is related to the 5456. So click on select to parameters. Firstly I will select or deselect all the parameters. From this I will select compression strength, yield strength, yield strength of shear reinforcement, maximum main, maximum secondary, MD1, MD2. Click on OK. So after that we have to define the parameters. So initially I will add the compressive strength as per my considerations as M30 grade concrete. Click on add option. Just I am selecting FI main reinforcement, which is related to the 500 FE 500 grade steel. Click on add option. Again in the same process just I am adding section reinforcement is also 500 grade 500,000. Click on add option. Again I am selecting maximum main, let us consider here as 20 mm bars. Click on add. Maximum secondary 16 mm, click on add. Again I am selecting MD1 16 mm diameter, add option. MD2 let us consider as 12 mm diameter, add option, close option. So after that we have to select the comments option here. Click on design beam command, click on add. Design column command, click on add. Takeoff command, click on add option. Select the takeoff option, click on add option, close option. So after that we have to assign this respected question marks. select FC value by using assign to view option, assign yes option. So after that we have to select the FY main, which is related to the FE 500 gray steel. So select that, click on assign to view option, assign option, yes option. Again in the same process you have to select the section reinforcement values as per the design considerations. Let's consider section reinforcement, assign to view option, assign option, yes option. So after that we have to select the maximum main, which is related to the 20 mm diameter. Select the maximum main, assign to view, assign yes option. So again I'm selecting maximum secondary, which is related to the 16 mm diameter bar. Assign to view option, assign option, yes option. Now we have to select the MD1, go to click on assign to view, assign option, yes option. Again in the same process, just I'm selecting MD2, click on assign to view option, assign option, yes option. Now we have to select the design beam command, go to select design beam command, select option beams parallel to X condition. Again I'm selecting beams parallel to Z condition system, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes option. Select the design column option here. Let us consider the design column option, which is related to the Y direction properties. Go to select beams parallel to Y condition, click on assign to selected beams, assign yes. So after that we have to assign the design element, click on assign to view, assign yes option. So after that we have to do the analysis again for the designing purpose also. Go to analysis and print, add your no print option, close option. Again I'm selecting analyze option, run analysis, save it. So again we have to check for the zero errors for this respected model under considerations of this respected load cases and grade of the concrete. Okay, so here my model is analyzing for the zero errors. So it will take around 10 minutes or 15 minutes, depends upon your considerations of the program. So after 15 minutes of analysis, here my model is showing here as zero errors. Go to post processing mode again, click on done option again. So here we have to select any one of the beam. Just I'm selecting the beam which is at first story. So before that initially we have to deselect the deflection diagram. So here I'm selecting the beam at the first story, double click on it, click on concrete design. This is the concrete design result, which is related to the first floor beam, which is having 6 bars at the top reinforcement and 3 bars at the bottom reinforcement. In the same process you can check any one of the beam, depends upon your considerations. So click on concrete design here. This is the top story beam, which is consisting of 3 bars at the top reinforcement, which is of 12 mm diameter, and bottom reinforcement will be consisting of 3 bars 12 mm diameter. So in the same process you can check the results, which is related to the column section also. So initially I'm considering the columns at the ground story. So this is the column reinforcement details for the ground story, which is consisting of 20 number of the bars, which is having 12 mm diameter. So again I will consider the 7 story column section. So click on concrete design. Now we can see it will be consisting of 12 number of the bars, which is consisting of 12 mm diameter. So in the same process you can consider, let us consider here as 14 story column, double click on it, click on concrete design. So here you can see the bar size will be of 20 mm, which is consisting of the 4 bars. From this respected point it was observed that if you increase the dimensions of your respected property, the reinforcement values is also increases. Okay, at the same time if you decrease the dimensions of the properties under the consideration, that is reinforcement values is also decreases. Okay, so after that we can see the output file, which is related to the STRAD output file for the designing of your respected G plus 14 story building structure. So click on the results option here. So click on the results option here, click on the concrete design. So it will be consisting of the concrete design, which is related to the beam design results and concrete column design results as per the considerations of the typical floor plan. Okay, for the respected G plus 14 story building under the various sizes of the beams and various sizes of the columns and various sizes of the slab sections. Okay, so this is a complete process analysis and designing of G plus 14 story building with various sizes of the column, various sizes of the beam and various sizes of the slab by using STRAD Pro VATI software. If you have any queries about this respected video, please text me your questions in the below comment box. I will try to give the answer for that respected question. Thank you.